We want to welcome you to another episode of Burrito On The Go. And we have a special today. We have been speaking about how we see the economy, the confidence that is there, and we get the chance to sit with a captain of industry. We're here at Stewart's Automotive, and we're gonna have a discussion with the managing director, Duncan Stewart. And to help lead that discussion, we're gonna have Roald Pinnock, our corporate finance executive, who's gonna lead us in that time.
At some point in your life, you want to own a new car, right? So, you know, it's quite appealing to somebody who wants to make that shift to owning the car for the first time.
Yeah.
And new car smell.
Yes.
But not only that, you know, reliability of a new car and the solidness of a new car, you know? Yeah.
So, Duncan, thank you very much for sitting with us. We wanted to start out just talking about how you see the current economic environment in Jamaica.
I think, like everybody else, I'm very positive about Jamaica. In my lifetime, it has never been this good. You know, confidence with consumers, confidence with business colleagues, and our own confidence is saying let's invest and let's grow.
Okay, so with that kind of confidence, what does that mean for Stewart's Automotive?
So we're in an environment where we're providing transportation needs as well as material handling, construction equipment, etc. So naturally, a growing economy is excellent for our business. And, you know, we're seeing it right now. You know, people are buying cars to do work and people are buying luxury cars because they're feeling good about where they are.
Okay. We talk a lot about macroeconomic environments, and at our shop we talk about interest rates and inflation. Mm-hmm. But with interest rates being at historic lows and inflation being historically low as well, how does that translate for your clients and how does it translate into your operating business?
So clearly this have impacts on costs, right? Low inflation, low interest rates means that costs are low. Low for our customers, right, and low for us. So it means that we can invest in capital equipment, and it means our customers can buy capital equipment like cars and material handling equipment, etc. So for me, it's overall a great thing that Jamaica is where it is right now, and I only see us getting better.
Okay, so on the back of all that, you've seen an uptick in your operating numbers?
Absolutely. Our business is driven by selling both cars and service, and people's willingness to pay depends on how good they're feeling about their earnings. So what we're seeing now is that people are willing to buy more expensive cars than in the past. Businesses are buying more equipment and trucks and so on than they have in the past. And we're not fighting about service bills.
Important. So as far as consumer confidence, is that just a academic number, or does it have real implications for your business flow?
Well, I think that cars are a leading indicator of how people feel about the situation they're in. And by that I mean, you know, when we had the 2008 Lehman crash, you know, what happened in Jamaica is that we thought that we were insulated from it. But the car industry saw it very quickly. In the first year, car sales dropped 48%. In the second year, car sales dropped 28%. I'm giving you that long-winded explanation because what it is that people can delay buying a car, right? If you have a car already, you don't need to buy a new one if you're not feeling confident. And what we're seeing now is that people are confident. So people are buying new cars sooner rather than later. They're not delaying their decisions. And more importantly, people are buying vehicles to do work. And when you see people buying things to do work, it's a very good leading indicator.
Okay, and your outlook from this point, looking forward maybe 12 to 18 months?
Right, I see growth ahead. So that means growth in units sold, particularly. Our industry is a very, very competitive business, so it's not something that you just take for granted. You have to work at it. But nonetheless, I see growth ahead.
So if I'm a young professional in the market for a new car, why Stewart Automotive?
Well, you know, we're Jamaica's premier automotive group. Our reputation is built on service. Service is not only about how we treat you, but service is also about what we deliver. So we have the best availability for spare parts, we have the best service capability, and we have the widest variety of choice. So those are all reasons you shouldn't leave us off of your radar when you're looking for a car, or truck, or backhoe, or forklift, and so on.
That's Duncan Stewart, Managing Director of Stewart's Automotive. Thank you very much.
Raul, I really found that conversation to be very valuable.
Yeah, I agree. I think there was real economy connections. So yes. We talk a lot about macroeconomics, we talk a lot about interest rates and inflation in finance. But what I liked about the interview is that you get to see firsthand the difference that interest rates can really make for the affordability for a car, for example, and business sales. So I really like how it connected, and you know, that should put the opportunity landscape on the display.
No, for sure. And this is why I really remind clients that opportunities abound.
Yeah, for sure. Interest rates matter.
Interest rates matter.